I'd like to welcome everyone to the 2016 WCTV Clapper Awards, where we recognize our volunteers and producers for the best WCTV programs over the past year. On behalf of my staff, Joanna Perino, John Bernard, James Bernard, Drew Bixler, and Brian Dodge, I'd like to thank all of you for coming and sharing this evening with us. Before we present our first award, I'd like to pay tribute to someone very special. As many of you know, our longtime producer, volunteer, and friend, Charlie Aukerman, passed away on October 29th at the age of 77. He served as a cable commission member for nearly 30 years and was the producer of many WCTV programs, including Let's Talk with Joe Gaines and Bo Dews and Wadsworth Week in Review. He received many Clapper Awards and the Outstanding Service Award in 2010. Charlie will be dearly missed, but the contributions he made to WCTV and the Wadsworth community will continue on. In Charlie's honor, we dedicate tonight's presentation to him. So let's get started. First, I'd like to welcome everybody on Facebook Live. Drew is doing Facebook Live for us tonight, so I want to welcome everybody watching on Facebook. We're lucky to have Tom Stugmeyer with us tonight. He's taking our pictures. And we'd ask that all of the winners please come to receive your award here and then go over next to the wall and Tom will take your picture so we can put up on Facebook and have for our memories. And then we hope that you'll also post your own pictures from tonight and post them on Facebook and tag Joanna so she can also share them as well. We are going to kick off our awards presentation with the Milestone Awards, which are given to those who produce 100 programs and up. We'd like to present the first award to Medina County Auditor Mike Kovac for producing his 400th program, Community Connections, Art in the Park, that he produced on August 12th of this year. And Miles Howell is accepting for Mike. All right, we'll make sure Mike gets that award. The next Milestone Award is pretty special. It's only the second time in WCTV history that we presented a Milestone Award for this many shows, 1,000. Congratulations to Roger Polk for producing his 1,000th program, The Ultimate Game Paintball, on September 21st of this year. Roger? We commissioned a local artist, George Parmalee, to create something special for Roger. This art piece commemorates his 1,000th episode and all the things that make Roger's paintball show so entertaining. His paintball equipment, his favorite on-sale snacks, his crock pot of squirrel stew, his furry friends, past and present, and of course, a tribute to his service to our country as a U.S. Marine. Hoorah, Roger. Yeah. This original will hang in the WCTV studios next to Gene and Joe's 1,000th portrait, and we have the one and only framed print for Roger. Congratulations, and we're looking forward to 1,000 more.
Wow. Thank you.
Do I want to say anything? Yeah, right. Well, first off, thank you to everybody in the community. It's been a lot of fun. It has been so much fun. We have come so far just in the last,
let me hold this for you, sir.
Thank you. The last 18 years or so that I've been doing it. And we have so much fun. That's why I said if it's ever got to where it wasn't fun, I wouldn't do it. So for Facebook Live people, right? This is Joanna's thing. We're going to go Facebook Live. I've probably got maybe 60 seconds before they pull me off. Call this number if you're on Facebook Live. My wife is right now is livid. She said, so her phone needs to hum or buzz in her purse. The rest of you, check under your seat. There's a ticket. You think I'm lying? Check under your seat. There is a white ticket taped under somebody's seat right now. This is what we do a lot of on our show. There, now they're checking.
It's on the...
It's underneath somebody's chair.
On the rail.
It's on the rail. It's on the rail underneath your seat.
Right side.
The last two digits are 13. Hey, honey, check my seat. I could win, too. What we have been doing on the show...
Uh-oh.
We got a winner. There we go. Isn't this fun? Yeah. Somebody called? All right, get their name and number. My wife's going to get their name and number from Facebook Live. I'll take her personal cell phone number. I got to change that now. What we're going to do is, on the next paintball show on Wednesday when we film, you have one of the new $10 Ohio Lottery tickets that's going to be in your name. I bought it. You got it. We're going to split it. So if it's a $1 million winner, we're going to split. This is what I do. Everybody else, they know. But thank you very much. I mean, it's just, it's so much fun. And I want to thank Tom Stugmeyer, because I may not get up here again tonight, people. So on Wadsworth Community Radio, what we're going to be doing on Saturdays in December from 8 to 10 is a lot bigger of what you just did. We're going to have a radio from 8 to 10, and we're going to hide an envelope somewhere in Wadsworth. It's worth $100 in Ohio Lottery tickets. I buy them, you fly and you find them, I'll split it with you. You come to the station, and we're going to do that. Try to make somebody's Christmas, help pay for their Christmas, and just get the community involved and have a lot of fun. So I'm having a blast. I don't know about you. Thanks to Suprema for the food. I'm eating during the whole thing. And thank you. This is awesome. I'm with the polka guys. I'm with the polka guys.
Congratulations. I might also let everyone know it took about a week for that smell of the squirrel stew to get out of the studio before we could produce another show in there. Okay, now on to the clapper categories. In your program is a list of all the nominees, so you can follow us along. The Clapper Award winners were selected based on quality and popularity. Voting took place in October. We received over 3,000 ballots this year. The nominees were then sent to a panel of media professionals for judging and quality, for judging on quality, production, content, and their overall reaction to the show. This year, our three judges were from Orlando, Florida, Hiram University, and in Southern Ohio. The runner-up and honorable mention in each category will receive a framed certificate,
which I can't show because it has a name on it.
And of course, the winner will receive the beautiful WCTV Clapper Award that has a new design this year. So, awesome. So let's find out who the winners are. Our first category is Best School Event, and the honorable mention goes to Isham Veterans Ceremony, produced by Terry Livers and Isham School.
Okay, so now, if you want to... you're welcome. Tom.
Runner-up in the Best School Event category goes to...
Did you mention stepping in over here? For the pictures.
Oh, yeah. So for pictures, once you get your award, step over by the wall, and then they'll get your picture over that way.
So I'm not in everyone.
That's right. Okay, the runner-up for Best School Event is the 2015 Pumpkin Decorating Contest at Franklin School, produced by Roger Havens. Okay, and now for the clapper winner, we'll watch our screen here for the winner. The 2015 Veterans Day, produced by Sacred Heart of Jesus School.
Veterans Day, I hope you feel the very first support.
And accepting for the students and Sacred Heart School is Bill Adams.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that. First of all, thanks to WCTV for the many things that they do for our community and for our schools. We truly appreciate it. Secondly, is that this is our favorite day of the year. Honoring the veterans is just an incredible situation at Sacred Heart of Jesus School. It brings a lot of joy and a lot of pride to us. If you would be there in the gymnasium, you would see that. This was just a small glimpse of the token of appreciation that we have for the people who gave us everything. And we truly appreciate them, and we'll continue to do this as long as we possibly can. God bless America.
Our next category is Best Look Into Our Schools, and the honorable mention goes to Sacred Heart Thanksgiving, produced by Sacred Heart School, and Bill Adams will be accepting after his picture.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you.
The runner-up in the Best Look Into Our Schools category goes to Wadsworth City Schools, the STEM Water Bottle Challenge, produced by Steve Brady and Nance Watts. And now if we watch our screen up here, we'll find out who the Clapper winner is. Medina County Student of the Year Awards, produced by Mike Kovac.
Our Student of the Year, male Student of the Year from Wadsworth High School is Riley Durth. Riley is ranked fourth out of his class of 371. He was also selected as a Hugh O'Brien Leadership Representative for Wadsworth, as well as serving as president of National Honor Society. A Huddle member, he participated in band, cross country for 4 years, and the track team. A scholar athlete for 4 years, Riley has volunteered at the Senior Center and currently works at Great Oak Cinemas. I didn't catch that part, where I used to work as a high school student at Wadsworth High School. The son of Steve and Michelle Durth, Riley plans to attend college at the University of Central Florida, majoring in electrical engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, Riley Durth.
Again, we'll accept this award on Mike's behalf. Our next category is the Best School Performance, and the honorable mention goes to the WMS Spring Choir Concert, produced by Andrea Atzinger, and Ralph Mays is accepting. The runner-up in the Best School Performance goes to the 2016 Sacred Heart Talent Show, produced by Sacred Heart School, and once again, Bill Adams is accepting. And now we'll watch the screen again for our Clapper winner in the Best School Performance. Aladdin, produced by Terry Livers.
You ever get a tune in your head and you can't get it out? After editing for about 3 weeks with that, with four different cameras, I still sing that song. But Mrs. Adley and those children work so hard at these things. They need the pat on the back. They do a great job, and so do the three J's, and now they get a little troublemaker here with the Facebook stuff. Progress. Thank you very much.
Our next category is the Best Youth Production, and the honorable mention goes to First Christian Church Preschool Christmas Program, produced by Colin Wright. The runner-up in the Best Youth Production goes to Alibi, produced by the WHS Drama Department promo, or produced by Rachel Williams. And now for the Clapper winner in the Best Youth Production goes to Legacies of Life, an Eagle Scout project produced by Brandon Bauer.
We met in high school and dated in high school. And then when we graduated, she went to work and I moved away to college for 3 years and then came home and we got married. And she put me through 1 year of college and 4 years of grad school. And then she was able to quit work. I went to work.
Well, I used to install a music system for St. Catherine's Church in Cleveland for this kids to have a Saturday night dance. So I carried all this stuff over. You know, the owner of my store let me take this stuff over there to set it up for him. And this one night, this girl comes to me and she said, "Would you mind taking me home?" And I said, "No." She said, "Well, this guy wants to take me home and I don't want to go home with him." So that's how we got together. So, and probably we kissed goodnight, I guess. So.
And Brandon's parents are accepting.
Brandon really wanted to be here. He was sorry he couldn't make it because he is in Toledo at the University of Toledo. He asked if I could read a speech that he had wrote, just a short one. He said, "Receiving this WCTV Clapper Award is truly an honor. I never thought I would ever be receiving one. My short documentary, Legacies of Life, was created with the intention of creating awareness among our community to volunteer with the residents, not only at Liberty Residence, but all our homes in our community. With the help of all my friends, family, troop, and Liberty residents, I was able to produce this documentary, and with the kindness of WCTV, I was able to distribute my documentary onto television, which made it viewable across all platforms of media. I want to say a few thank yous. Thank you to WCTV and all the voters who voted for my documentary. Thank you to Hannah Park, Sarah Hoff, and my entire team to help produce and edit the documentary. Thank you to my mom, dad, and sister for always pushing me to do my best. Thank you to every leader and scout of Boy Scout Troop 401 for pushing me to be the best leader I can be. Thank you to Liberty Residents for allowing me to film in the home and allowing me to get to know your astounding residents. This award is a huge honor to receive, so thank you very much.
Our next category is Best Documentary, and our honorable mention goes to Inside Wadsworth, the Community Dog Park, produced by Jim Kovacs. Runner-up in Best Documentary goes to V is for Victory, an interview with Dale Hughes, produced by Deborah and James Kenny.
Congratulations. You're welcome. Congratulations. And you want to step that way and get your picture? Okay.
And now we'll watch our screen for the Clapper winner for Best Documentary. The 2016 Republican National Convention, produced by Joe Gaines and Roger Polk.
But I'll tell you what, this is part of American history. And when you taught history like I did, you got to see history, see it for yourself, be a part of it. Current events are that, current, and they're happening all around. And you got to make sure that you become a part of it if you can. And Roger and I have been a part of it. We've seen an awful lot today. We've talked to not only just people who are delegates and people who are politicians, but we've talked to the average American, the Clevelander, people who are from here, people who have seen the city grow, seen it change, see all the changes happening in the country also. We're really impressed in many ways. It's very, very interesting. The police have been nothing but friendly and very tolerant and very easy to talk to.
Joe Gaines and Roger Polk. I know you're all wondering, how in the world did we get these two clearance to get there? I know.
Tell your story.
Go ahead.
No, please. They've heard enough of me tonight, Joe.
Well, it was an honor to go to the National Convention and represent the City of Wadsworth. And I have a lot to say that's only good about the City of Wadsworth. And I want to thank not only WCTV for this award, for all their help and encouragement, but also a couple people that got me involved, and that's Charlie Ackerman and Dave Fry, who really helped me to become part of the community and part of Wadsworth. I wish the result could have been a little different at the convention in some ways, but it was interesting and it was a good experience. Thank you.
Next year, we are going to go to the World Series when the Indians are in it again for WCTV. We're going to cover that.
Congratulations to both of you. The next category is Best Religious Message, and the honorable mention goes to Selfish, When Marriage Relationships Turn Cold, produced by Adam Barton, Larry States, Kyle Wright, and the Mosaic Church Wadsworth, formerly Grace and Truth. Larry States is accepting. The runner-up for the Best Religious Message goes to What Catholics Really Believe, The New Age Deception, produced by Tim Perry.
We're Italian, we kiss.
And now for our Clapper winner in Best Religious Message. Light from Above, New Testament Christian Knows the Difference Between the Testaments, produced by David R. Kenny.
Some people think when they come to the Bible, they think they're just picking up, you know, some other book, and they have no problem with it being a history book, but they don't realize that the Bible is not written in strict chronological order. And that's something that people don't understand. And so when they go to read it, they struggle. Another thing that they don't recognize is some books of the Bible covers greater time spans than the other. For example, the Old Testament covers thousands of years, but the New Testament, about 100 years. So if you read the New Testament, it's a lot more easier maybe than you read when you read the Old Testament, because the time frame is a lot smaller. So there's a lot of variables, the type of literature that's involved. Those kinds of things. Now, the Old Testament has 39 books, and the New Testament has 27, for a total of 66 books. Now let's take a look at the Old Testament, and we'll just go through these sections. The first section is the first five books. Sometimes it's called the Pentateuch. Pentateuch meaning five books.
David Kenny. Congratulations.
I used to think if you had the longest title, you'd win. I don't know how they fit all that on there. But I want to thank House to House. They let me use the graphics. Also, these lessons came from Memphis School of Preaching Lectureship. Of course, WCTV, GBN, and other people have a large part to do in this program in these particular episodes. So thank you very much. And, of course, my family's here and always grateful to see them and everybody that voted. Thank you.
I'll also real quickly mention, too, this year David has been producing another program, which is Bible Readings and Hymns, which is not only an audio program for radio stations, but also a video program that will air on WCTV and GBN beginning this January. And it's Bible Readings through the New Testament on a daily basis. Our next category is Best Worship Service, and the honorable mention goes to Wadsworth United Methodist Church Contemporary Service. Somebody here from the church to accept?
Rachel, are you accepting?
All right. The runner-up goes to First Christian Church. Accepting is Bob Parmalee. And now for the clapper winner in the Best Worship Service. Mosaic Church Wadsworth, produced by Adam Barton and Larry States.
Jesus is talking to this woman, and they're getting in this conversation, and Jesus is like, hey, go get your husband. And she's like, I don't have a husband. And Jesus is like, well, yeah, that's true, because you have five. And if you're over here, you're like, Jesus, you can't say that to people. You can't tell somebody they've had five husbands. But so he kind of lays on some truth here, like, hey, your love life is messy. That's really bad. But then the amazing part with this woman is he then proceeds to tell her that he is the Messiah, and he shows her the path to life. She's one of the first people to ever find out that Jesus is the Messiah. She's one of the first ones in history. He gives her that place of honor, even though he just laid on her that she has a really messy love life. So he holds this truth, and he holds love, and he holds them both, and he gives her both. He holds them both, and he gives them perfectly. The woman caught in adultery. Right, these Pharisees, they come and they throw this woman down. They say she was caught in adultery. Let's stone her. And Jesus says, hold up a minute. You know, okay, the one without sin, you can throw the first rock. And they all walk away because they know they can't do that. And then Jesus says to her, no one condemned you. Neither do I condemn you. So he loves her. And then he says, go and sin no more. He gives her truth. He does both. He doesn't just say you're cool. He says, yeah, I don't condemn you. I love you. Stop it. You can't live like that.
Larry States.
That's been quite a year for us. We have made some changes. Our congregation continues to grow, and as a result, we outgrew our sanctuary. And about 6 weeks ago, we ended up doing services at the Performing Arts Center, starting services at the Performing Arts Center and at the high school. And all I can say is that I really appreciate the fact that WCTV gives the area churches a platform for inspiration. I think we reach a lot of people who may never walk across the threshold of our church. And I think it's a great service that they provide. And I know one thing, I'm from Akron, and they put their cable system to shame. So it's... This is one of the few in the country that has this quality of programming and allows the churches to get involved as well. And it's quite a credit to the community of Wadsworth. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Our next category is Best Performing Arts, and the honorable mention goes to Rymer Road Baptist Church Christmas Cantata, produced by the Rymer Road Baptist Church. Is someone here from the church? The runner-up in Best Performing Arts goes to Wadsworth Community Band and Choir Concert, produced by Mark Sterling. Jim Kovacs, a member of the community band, is accepting. And now for the Clapper winner in the Best Performing Arts. The 50s Variety Show, produced by the Suprema Senior Center Performers.
Elvis is alive and living in Wadsworth! Long live the king of rock and roll! I'm gonna do my first song, You Ain't Nothing But a Hound Dog. What'd you call it, Stan?
It's nothing but a groundhog.
Thanks for raining on my parade, Stan.
You ain't
nothing but a hound dog. Everyone, cry the whole time. Oh,
you ain't nothing but a hound dog.
Boy from Tupelo, Mississippi, and I'm here to rock your world. Oh, oh. I think I hurt myself. Strum those guitars. Let's go. Oh.
Come on up.
Everybody, all of them. Come on.
Come on up.
All the performers up here.
On behalf of the Suprema Senior Center and this amazing group of Young at Heart performers, I'd like to thank WCTV and the voters for this illustrious award, and congratulations to the Young at Heart performers. You rock.
We're just a bunch of senior citizens having a great time. And if you've ever been down to the Senior Center, you ought to come down. It's really great. And hey, guys, we're rollers! Roll!
Yep, looks like they're going to have to go to the hallway. All right, our next category is Best Public Awareness. And the honorable mention goes to Inside Wadsworth, Opiate and Heroin Awareness, produced by Jim Kovacs. The runner-up for Best Public Awareness goes to Your Health and Wellness, Project Dawn, produced by Mark P. Grisco. Hey, who's the 98-year-old rowdy guy out there? Okay, now for our Clapper winner and the Best Public Awareness. Law Talk, Medina County Specialized Dockets, produced by John Celebrezzi.
Hello, and welcome to Law Talk. My name is John Celebrezzi, and I'm the co-founder of the Celebrezzi Zangi Community Legal Education Project, as we call it CZCLEP for short. Our organization provides continuing education about the judiciary and legislature to attorneys, judges, government officials, and the general public. As a career educator, I recognize early on how important legal matters are and how they impact our lives. I am the nephew of the late Anthony J. Celebrezzi, who was the popular five-term mayor of Cleveland and a member of President Kennedy's cabinet. As a tribute to his lifetime commitment to the legal process, we dedicate this show.
Thank you so much for this award. I accept it on behalf of a lot of people. A special thanks to what I always call the three J's, but it looks like the list is getting a little longer here. But we have some great people working at the studio. Thank you.
Our next category is Best Promotional, and the honorable mention goes to Wadsworth Youth String Ensemble promo produced by Bruce Tackett. The runner-up goes to Let's Go Adventure Series number 53, Back to the Future Trilogy, Lake 8 Movies promo produced by Roger Polk. And now we'll watch our screen for the Clapper winner and the Best Promotional. And that award goes to Pay It Forward for Pets, produced by Georgette Thomas.
Without bricks and mortar, one could ask, how can you call yourself an animal rescue organization? After all, where are the animals? Pay It Forward for Pets effectively saves large numbers of cats and dogs in a very unconventional way through collaborative programs. And the good news is, because there's no costly overhead, no salaries paid, 100% of your contributions support the programs directly. This business model maximizes donor dollars and has proven to substantially decrease the amount of time animals are housed in shelters and potentially euthanized. In our efforts to get animals into homes, our team concentrates on conventional practices as well as those gray areas that most animal rescue groups do not have the time or resources to commit to. Now here is some more information about the work we do. Managing six programs that benefit animal rescue in the community, Pay It Forward for Pets probably is best known for our pet photography program. This program is designed to positively market each and every dog and cat that enters the shelter, and it creates a sense of excitement.
Georgette Thomas.
I don't even know what to say. I didn't think we would get anything this year, so I didn't plan anything. I want to thank John, and Johanna. We've been doing this probably, I don't even know how long now, maybe 5 years or more. I think more than that, actually. Yeah. Our little organization is still a little organization, but it continues to grow. And these platforms allow us to get our information, our education out there to the community. And it's the only way that we can share our message and the importance in responsible pet parenting and animal welfare. We have a new endeavor we're embarking on because of the support of the community, and this falls actually under our humane education program, and we will be offering. Should I talk about that? We're located in Summit County, Akron, Ohio, and we are going to be opening up a doggy daycare as well as a boarding facility and a resale shop to continue to support the six programs that we bring to the community to support animal welfare. Without this platform, as well as some other opportunities that we have, we can't get our message out there and we can't get the support to continue the programs. And for that, we thank everybody, and thank you guys too.
Our next category is Best Special Event, and the honorable mention goes to Community Connections, produced by Medina County, or on the Medina County Fair, produced by Mike Kovac. Runner-up in the Best Special Event goes to Props and Pistons, produced by Bob Parmalee. And now the Clapper winner goes to the Buckeye Invitational WHS Marching Band, produced by Ray Erbst. We'll be right back.
Well, as my philosophy always is, and that is to bring the event back home for the rest of the residents who weren't able to attend. So I thank WCTV, and when I film something like that, it's always a guess as to what section of the band might be still. And so, as you saw in that clip, why it just so happened that, you know, 4 or 10 students happened to be relatively still at a moment. So I really don't know who those are, but what I try to do is, as it's so hard to tell who the students are with the caps on, I try to get the faces as best I can. So it's all to bring it back for the parents and relatives and friends that can't be there. So thank you.
The next category is Best Sports and Recreation, and the honorable mention goes to Wadsworth Youth Football, produced by Patrick Kilker. Runner-up for Best Sports and Recreation, the Ultimate Game Paintball number 820, produced by Roger Polk.
I told Polka time I was moving to Canada if they won everything.
And now the Clapper winner for the Best Sports and Recreation Program. The WHS Varsity Volleyball, produced by Dan Witchie, Todd Grice.
Jody with the up, coming right back to you, Jody from Sophia. They're able to dig that. Good block. Libby and Haley up there in the front row. Sophia, Haley. They handle that. Jenna, off the touch. Sophia, quick one to Olivia Cheney. Trying to find a hole. All right, we should get one here. Let's go. Good pass. Set. To Olivia. In the back corner. Good shot. 4-1.
They call themselves My Three Dads Productions, so...
My three dads are minus one dad, Rick Johnson. It's real easy for us to do this. We just talk about our daughters out there, Kenzie Grice, Haley Witchie and Stacy Witchie, and Jenna and Jody Johnson. They were awesome on the volleyball team, and it made it very simple. But we appreciate WCTV and this award and all their help. They did it all for us. They taught us what to do, and it was a piece of cake. It was fun. Thank you.
This was definitely an exciting year for Wadsworth Sports, especially with the Lady Grizzlies winning the state basketball championship. Our sports crew does an excellent job of capturing every play. It's the most watched programming that we have on WCTV, so I'd like to recognize all of our crew members, and I hope they'd stand. John Bernard, of course, back there, James and Justin Bernard, Drew Bixler, Phil Dell, Roger Wright, and Gary Bernard, as well as our new football announcer, Robert Rickenbacker, and new basketball announcer Dave Major, for doing such a great job. Thank you very much for your dedication and all your hard work. Our next category is Best Instructional, and the honorable mention goes to Reversing the Aging Process, Be Active, Stay Active, produced by Gary Palmer. Runner-up for Best Instructional, The Health and Happiness Show, Surviving Cancer, and Homemade Applesauce, produced by Janet Hawkins. And now we'll watch the monitor here for the Clapper winner and the best instructional. Growing Gary's Garden, produced by Gary Bernard.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to episode number 2 of Growing Gary's Garden. I think we'll have a little review of what we did in the first episode. Right now, this first bed is the blueberries, and you can see that they're blooming nicely. We have blueberries in here that will mature early, middle, and late year. There's about 9 or 10. And also, this bed here is the asparagus, which I told you also that this may be an experiment gone bad, but I found on sale some roots. So they were about $3 for 6 of them, so I planted an extra six holes, and they're about 6 inches deep. You lay the roots down, and then you bury it with 3 inches of soil. As it comes up, then you bury it to the top, and hopefully we'll have a few more for next year.
Gary Bernard.
I never met a microphone I didn't like, so I hope you don't think there's any nepotism involved in this award. There are 3 generations of Barnards on WCTV, and many thanks especially to James. He helped me with the idea. He did all the filming, editing, and the graphics, and it's greatly appreciated, and we had a good time doing it. So thanks, everybody. It's a fun thing to do. And James, you got to come up and have a picture taken. Thank you.
Our next category is Best Informational, and the honorable mention goes to Pay It Forward for Pets, Breast Cancer, produced by Georgette Thomas. The runner-up for Best Informational goes to Animal Crackers number 414, Pet Dental Care, produced by Dr. Larry Markley at All Creatures Veterinary Clinic. And now the Clapper winner for the Best Informational Program. The High Street State Route 94 Project, produced by Harry Stark and Jim Kovacs.
Okay, Harry, we have now changed to a different access road. Why don't you tell us where we're at and what's going to be happening with the development of this new road?
Yeah, sure. We're at the Drug Mart Plaza, right across the street. We were just standing right across the street.
In the Kmart Drive.
In the Kmart Drive, the old Kmart Drive. And what's happening is a new access road is being installed here. And as you can see, as John pans, this road is going to go all the way behind Drug Mart, and it's going to wrap around Drug Mart and then come out on the other side, on the north side of Taco Bell. What this is doing is it's opening up the properties behind Drug Mart for development. They've kind of been landlocked a little bit back there. So it's the ability for those to open up their the development for those properties. And it's going to really make a great access movement throughout this plaza, Taco Bell, and really the Get-Go too, because the Get-Go and Aldi's will be connected to this whole access system.
Jim Kovacs.
Well, I'm sorry Harry couldn't be here tonight. He was really wanting to be here. He's out of state right now, so I'm sure he would have enjoyed standing here with me. But it's been a lot of fun doing those shows on the construction project. I know it's kind of painful right now, but when the project's done, I think everybody's going to love driving through that corridor. And I especially want to thank John. John's done a nice job. He actually comes out on location. We got pretty dirty doing those shows, trooping through dust and mud. So thank you very much, John. And if I would have brought my hard hat ahead, I know we were going to win. But thank you, everybody.
Our next category is Best Talk Show, and the honorable mention goes to Law Talk, Medina County Prosecutor Dean Holman, produced by John Celebrezzi. The runner-up in Best Talk Show goes to Primetime, the Eagle Scout Brandon Bauer, produced by Kathy Hall and the Wadsworth Older Adults Foundation. And now our Clapper winner for Best Talk Show. That award goes to Your Health and Wellness, Pain Management, produced by Mark P. Grisco.
Pretty much anything you can do to treat pain short of surgery, we can offer at our clinic. Mm-hmm. And it's wonderful because we all work together. We have chiropractors, acupuncture, massage therapists, physical medicine rehab doc like myself, fellowship trained interventional anesthesiologist. We all sure. work on one team. The chiropractor can explain what a neural stimulator is. Our anesthesiologist can explain how a chiropractic adjustment works. We all believe in what everybody does. Sure. You know, if somebody comes in to me, an MD, and I say, I evaluate them and I think they need acupuncture, I'll send for acupuncture. You know, it's so nice. We all work together. We can control the quality of our product
sure.
because we all are on the same page.
I think the patients can appreciate, too, that whole team approach. I mean, it probably just helps treatment just flow that much better for them.
They really do. And, you know, we like to keep everything under one roof because if somebody, say, gets an epidural somewhere else and it goes bad or it doesn't work, we don't know how it was done. We don't have any specifics. Here we have the quality control, and we can, you know, mitigate for those variables.
Sure.
Mark Grisco and Adam Coleman.
I just looked at Adam, our host. I said, please don't allow me to forget anybody. I'm so excited. So thank you. How about if I start out with this? Thank you, everyone. There we go. And thank you, WCTV, that allows us, obviously, to do this. None of this is possible. And all this happiness in this room, none of this happens without them. So thank you, Cleveland Clinic, Akron General, Visiting Nurse Service. I know it's a long name, but they allow us to do this program. They see the benefit in education in the community. Thank you, Adam, for always being so professional and a fantastic host. And I always thank my wife, who also puts up with me when I'm trying to figure out the audio levels, and you guys know what all that is. So we edit forever, so thank you.
Yeah, I just want to say thank you, too. You know, this is a great escape for us. You know, you're going through a very stressful day at work, and you get away for a good hour, 2 hours, and to film this show. It's so fun for us, and it's kind of an escape from reality, so we love it. So just thank you.
Our next category is Best Entertainment. And the honorable mention goes to the Not So Newlywed Game, produced by Suprema Senior Center. The runner-up in Best Entertainment goes to the 2015 Scare on the Square and Thriller, produced by Bob Parmalee and Tom Stugmeyer. And now for the Clapper winner for Best Entertainment Program goes to Polka Time Again, Memories of a Sunday Afternoon, produced by Gene Kovac and Joe Gabosa.
News to report from the Shenango Valley. I'm sure all my friends back there know about this, but apparently Chick O'Neill's wife Alice has been playing cards with a bridge club for a number of years, and good old Chick never picked her up on time, and last week he showed up on time, and the bridge club members were in shock because his wife always spoke of him as my late husband. But after I heard that, I got talking to him, and they've been married for 62 years, and I said, what's the secret? He said, well, when we got married, we spoke to each other and said, no matter if we were rich or poor, we would go out twice a week. He said, Alice goes out on Tuesday, I go out on Thursday. So there you are, Joe. Schemer Murphy's secret of success for a long marriage.
Think about that. Okay. Maybe that'll help others out.
Okay. Well, now we're going to play a tune. We got this tape from our good friend Jan over in Amsterdam. And I don't think there's any translation to this. The group is Die Meyerhofer, and it's a tune called Ram Tam Tam. I think that's a universal term.
Gene and Joe.
I'm going to keep this brief because my favorite program is on at 8 o'clock tonight. And I also have an announcement. Joe and I are considering retiring as soon as our replacement is available. And when Roger Polk gets done with his accordion lessons and learns how to speak Slovenian, we're out of here.
Yeah, I think it'd make a good replacement, and it's not that hard to play that button box, Roger. Oh, but you know, one of the things, Gene, I'd like to thank is our wives. You know, like in my case, she makes sure that I get up in time in order to get to the program, and when we changed from 9 o'clock to 10 o'clock, or no, we went from 10:30 to 10 o'clock, that made a big problem for me, but she got me all straightened out on it. Thanks, Ann.
And now, one of the most highly coveted awards of the evening, the Host with the Most Award. The staff of WCTV selects the recipient based on the three P's of being a host: preparedness, presentation, and professionalism of their productions and the interviews they conduct. We would like to invite the 2015 Host with the Most, Peggy Pogan, to come forward and crown this year's recipient.
Hello. I'm tall. I am tall. Hi, everyone. This year's recipient has been a TV host for 18 years. Naturally, you'll often find this person taking 1 minute or sometimes 15 minutes to educate her viewers on how to make a better you. She is not an MD, but we often feel better after hearing the information she provides. We joke that her guests are victims because you never know what she's going to extract from them or put into them. Viewers have seen their share of toxins and earwax coming out, and lots of supplements, wheatgrass, stress-reducing treatments, homemade foods, and natural remedies going in. All of these ingredients make for one of the healthiest and happiest show hosts we have. It's my pleasure to present the 2016 Host with the Most Award to roll video.
If we're having some stress issues, we need to get your body back into balance. There's many things you can use. We can use maybe some valerian root, which is an herbane. I have seven flowers we can muscle test you. We have anxiousness. These are all herbal supplements rather than being on Xantex, a medication that maybe has some side effects. I know it's addictive, it's habit forming. And there's also, I'm using tree essence now, which are for the emotions. And we have different ones for stress, anxiety, fear, things like that. And that is like a liquid and you put it under your tongue. It's kind of like a homeopathic, but it uses tree, it uses the leaf, the fruit, or the bark. And they process it by putting it in the sun, and it's in distilled water with a little bit of alcohol to preserve it. So it's kind of like...
Janet?
I'm going to crown you the 2016 Host with the Most. just wear this all year when you do your parades and your you know, tour where you get make personal appearances. And
thank you very much.
Welcome.
Now, I don't know whether to be serious or to be fun.
Here's
but,
your award.
Oh, thank you so much. First of all, I want to tell you, I have my digestive enzymes with me. If anybody's having digestive issues, come to my table and I'll give you a couple. Now also, on plan number, okay, I'm back there. Number two is, does anybody need a colon cleanse? Maybe we have some gas, maybe we have some diarrhea, constipation. We can take care of that too. But just remember, in my opinion, we all need to supplement. Maybe D3 because we're going into wintertime. We don't have much sunshine. So anyway, thank you so much. And I want to thank the staff, the three J's. If I have a problem, Joanne is there, John's are there. And they're such a great staff to work with. And thank you. And may all of you be blessed with a great holiday. Thank you so much.
Janet, Janet, before you go too far, I'd like to recognize Janet and her program for being selected as a finalist in the Philo T. Farnsworth Video Awards presented by the Alliance for Community Media. This is a regional video competition encompassing six states with thousands of entries. In the interview talk show category, the health and happiness show Singing Crystal Bowls was recognized as a finalist. Now let's take a look at Janet's winning program.
As I was toning through the horse's body, just as I am with Rachel, the sound flows to the point where there's a blockage. So if I'm toning into the crown and my hand is here and I don't feel it, it means there's an energetic blockage between this point and the next point, and I begin to tone all the way through the body part until I find the blocked area.
And Janet got a, has a certificate.
This probably appeared a little unusual to you. I know when I was first approached about them being on the program, I had to think, okay, let me experience this first, and then we'll move forward, maybe. So I did experience it, and I actually could tell a difference. It is, the sound wave is a touch of healing, like an energy healing. Like next month for December, I'm having Michael Schaefer on, and he's a massage therapist. But he also incorporates Reiki and energy work. And we all have energy, and that is exactly what this sound was doing. Joanna, you had the treatment.
Yes, I was a victim.
Yes.
That we talked about, yes.
And she could really feel a difference because you have the CD as well. And I have it in my car, and I listen to the sounds when I'm driving my car. But when my husband gets in the car, he turns it off. So, but anyway, that's just what it was about. He is from California, so you know they're like 10 years ahead of us anyway. So at least we had an opportunity to experience it. And again, thank you very much.
Congratulations, Janet. Now we will present our Golden, Platinum, and Diamond Disc Awards that go to the programs with the most views on MyPeg Central. We received over 49,000 views this year, compared to last year with only a little over 18,000. That's a 172% increase in online viewing. Our first disc award is the Golden Disc. It is awarded to the program with the third most views on PEG Central. With 1,795 views, this award goes to Wadsworth City Schools Striving to be the Best, a series produced by Steve Brady and Nance Watts.
So
She's going to be sorry she missed it tonight. Yeah? Would you like?
In second place and winner of the Platinum Disc Award is the Ultimate Game Paintball, a series produced by Roger Polk with a total of 2,702 hits.
You got like a rock star wall, don't you?
I know. We're really doing good.
And the winner of the Diamond Disc Award with the most views for a series on PEG Central over the past year with a total of 4,082 views is Polka Time Again, produced by Gene Kovac and Joe Gabrosi.
These diamonds are heavy. That one's yours. You're welcome. That one's yours. Congratulations.
I just want to say I knew this was a big event when John dressed for the occasion.
Hey, Gene, I think maybe part of this was due to that the station in North Dakota. And they've kind of added to it. And then here, the new quarterback for the Philadelphia National Football League is from North Dakota. So they all go together.
This year, we also had a single program that had an exceptionally high amount of online views. With 613 views of one episode, we'd like to present the single program Diamond Disc Award to Tim Perry for What Catholics Really Believe, number 411, an interview with Father Pat Spicer.
For one show.
613 views on PEG Central for one show.
Great, thank you.
Thanks. As you know, the WCTV sports crew produces all the home WHS boys and girls basketball games. This year's girls season was an exciting one, and with the girls team winning the state championship, proof of that excitement was measured by the amount of views that they had on mypegcentral.com, 5,159 to be exact. To commemorate the state championship season and the record number of views, we'd like to present this special edition Ruby Disc Award to Coach Andrew Booth. Accepting for the coach is and Dr. Hill.
I'll just take a moment here to thank WCTV for all of their coverage of all of the events that happen in the school district. We are very fortunate as a community to have a local TV channel like this that helps to promote all of the different events that our students do. So thank you very much.
Now for our Outstanding Achievement Award Director's Chairs that we have over to my right here. These director chairs are presented to producers and volunteers in appreciation for their longtime commitment to WCTV. To date, we have presented over 40 chairs, and tonight we will present two more. It's very apparent that our first recipient believes in what we do. From the moment he began working in the Wadsworth school system, he became a local TV star and did a great job producing programs that have highlighted our students. As he strived to be the best at his job at Wadsworth High School, he also served the community as a member of the Wadsworth Cable Commission and was the co-host of Wadsworth City Schools with Dale Fortner. He continues to produce many programs for WCTV each year, but now showcasing the wonderful students of Sacred Heart School. He's a prime example of a person that sees the value of community media. It's my pleasure to present this Outstanding Achievement Award Director's Chair to Bill Adams. The next recipient is a great resource for WCTV. Whenever there is a topic that affects Wadsworth, he's ready and willing to produce a high-quality program that will provide valuable information to our residents. The recipient has been a producer for 13 years and has won numerous Clapper Awards, and in 2005 was crowned WCTV host with the most. He has served the city of Wadsworth since 2003 and continues to be one of WCTV's biggest cheerleaders. His efforts are appreciated by our viewers who enjoy watching his programs that give them an honest look inside Wadsworth. It's my pleasure to present this Outstanding Achievement Award Director's Chair to Jim Kovacs. The 2016 WCTV Clapper Awards has come to an end. Before we go, I'd like to give a big round of applause for the staff from the Suprema Cafe and Windfall Industries for their delicious dinner. Thank you, Kimberly, Molly, Nancy, and Joe. We appreciate their partnership. We appreciate their partnership in making this a great event. If you haven't visited the cafe at Suprema Senior Center, please do. The food and staff are fantastic. And don't forget to take home your popcorn cupcake that you all have at your table. Kimberly did such a great job on all of them. If you need help with your holiday parties, contact Kimberly at the cafe. She has all kinds of great ideas. We also appreciate Tom Stugmeyer for taking the pictures tonight, especially since because it's his birthday today. Happy birthday, Tom. So before we end, I'd like to ask that all the Clapper winners and host with the most, the Milestone Award winners, the Outstanding Achievement Award guys here, the Philo Award and Disc Award winners would remain for a few minutes up front here so we can get a group photo of everyone. Thank you all so much for all your efforts, and thanks for coming.